What I'm going to be doing is sifting out the worm cafe, the one where I had all those pot worms in there. I'm just looking at the material. I'm pretty sure it's ready to be harvested. I picked up these gorgeous bamboo and wire cages and just picked these up for $4. They were 11, so I bought a number of these yesterday, and I got the idea from AJ's Green Topics. He bought one of these to use, and yeah, I think they work really, really well. And this way I can also sift out the little cocoons and any little worms. Not sort of sure what size holes they are on there, but they're not huge, but it just gives me a really fine grade compost here. And I'm just using a little paintbrush to sort of scoop through and find any little cocoons in there that I'll keep. And I will put that in the tray when I put some egg carton shells in there. So that big stack of egg cartons that I had in there, I was planning on using that and just doing a bedding of that to start with. I'll just, yeah, try a different method. I normally use like mushroom compost. I buy that in the bags. But I thought I'll just, yeah, just try something a little different. Oh. Bird just tried to attack me. This way it's sort of gentle on everything if you're using a paintbrush. It's a clean one. And I can just sort of scoop all that over that side. And then I'll add a new pile to this. So just emptying out this top tray, I actually didn't come across one single worm in here. They must have all migrated down to the second tray. Yeah, nothing at all, which is kind of good if they've moved down. I wouldn't have thought they would have escaped, but you never know. Very many cocoons at the moment. They might be a little bit further down. Just giving you a lovely compost castings mixture here. I know I probably won't get every single one of them, but try and keep as many as I can. Otherwise they just go into the garden and they just free range around there. If I could join two of these together, I could make a little truffle or something. I'll just keep the bigger stuff in here. I mean, it is soft and broken down, But I'll just get the finer stuff out first. I'm just, yeah, really on the hunt for little cocoons at this stage. So out of that top tray there, I got one lovely great big, it's one of those big saucers. One of those, yeah, it's full with beautiful worm castings and compost. I'll use that to top up a couple of new pots. I'm going to be popping a couple of things in there. Some new veggies in there. But really, I didn't come across, well, maybe two cocoons. Not a great deal, but that's all good. They might all be in their second tray. I think I found some of them. All congregating. I did put in some egg carton yesterday. So obviously they like that. They're in amongst it. So that's what I'm going to be doing. I'll soak in some egg cartons and I'm going to pop that in the top tray. Okay, I'm sort of halfway through the second tray and I'm finding quite a few more worms down the bottom here. Just going to pop them through the little gentle sifter. Try not to shake them around too much. Been trying to pick some out there just to put into my not so scary Halloween bucket. Not that we celebrate Halloween here, but it was only 99 cents, and I like the colour. I thought that'll make a good little worm bucket. So I'll just let these soak in here right through, and then I'll tear them all up and I'll pop them in the top tier of that worm cafe, and yeah, make the worms a new bed. So I've just also got this worm farm bedding block. I've had this for a while actually, so I thought, well, okay, I'll mix this up and I'll put it in with the egg cartons that I've soaked in water and just tore up into small pieces. So I'll make two trays exactly the same, and yeah, we'll try a different method, different type of bedding this time, because last time I used the mushroom compost and a bit of shredded paper. So since I've got so many egg cartons, I thought I'll just put these ones to good use. So what I've done here is I've put in some of the worm bedding into this top tray. Just got a little bit more to put from this basket. Also acts as a really good sieve to get all the water out. And then just over here as well, I've just spread it across the top of the shredded cardboard. And the same with this one here. I've just got a little bit more to add to it. And yeah, we'll pop some worms back in there and settle them in for the night. I won't feed them tonight. I've got plenty of cardboard here, and they will actually eat this bedding as well. But I'll give them some food tomorrow. Okay, so I just have my little bucket of worms here. Wasn't as many in there as I thought. But that's a nice little worm ball, isn't it? So I'm going to put a handful just in here, just to keep them happy for now. I'll pop a, it's going to have another cover over the top. And I'll just tip the rest into this little one here. It wasn't as many as I thought was going to go into the other bin. but I'll have to go and scrounge some up from the big Dalek or Hungry Bin. But anyway, if they're happy enough, they'll start breeding up. So with the Worm Cafe now, it's got its tarp on it, it's just under the eaves, so it's keeping it out of the weather that little bit more. And hopefully the conditions are more favourable for them in there to be able to breed up, and we don't get that potworm problem again in it, because I think it did actually put a lot of stress on the worms. Because there wasn't as much food for them to eat, I think the potworms were sort of taking over from it. The composting worms generally, they know when to start breeding up just to keep up with the food supply. But in this case, they hadn't done that. So hopefully they're all settled into the new bed, and hopefully we don't get the potworms in there. And yep, they'll be having a nice, lovely little life in there. Okay, if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. And thanks for watching. We'll see you in the next video. Okay, bye.